Welcome to my humble abode. My name is Dr. Ness. Well, that doesn't matter. What you need to know is that I am a doctor, and I am very professional, very business. I specialize in all matters mental and Jesus. So join me, won't you, as we dive deep into the complexities of the natural human mind and how it can be impacted by the love of Christ. Let us begin by looking into example of what happens in an everyday scenario. The waiter messing up your order at a restaurant.
So then I said to her, step off, woman.
What? How'd you not go to jail for that? I actually remember this one time. I was this ring bearer for
all right, everybody, I got your food here. So I've got a wrap for Sean.
Thank you.
And we've got a wrap over here for Stephanie. And lastly, some Brussels sprouts for Karen.
Completely got my order wrong. What kind of psychopath orders the Brussels sprouts? I'm gonna have to let this guy have it.
I didn't order that, so I need you to go back in there and change it right now.
I'm so sorry. I really thought you said Brussels sprouts. At least that's what it sounded like.
Right, because chicken tartare and Brussels sprouts sound exactly alike.
Okay, I'm gonna go change this right now.
And he better hurry up.
Looks like we gave a customer the wrong order. I'm probably gonna spit in their food as soon as it's ready.
All right, I think we've seen enough here.
Karen was rude to the waiter and clearly ruined his day. But what if Karen tried to do everything she could so that she wouldn't offend the waiter, but still does it under her own strength?
So then I said to her, step off, woman.
What? How'd someone not die from that? Oh, I actually remember this one time, me and my friend Jerry.
I can't believe he got the order wrong. Okay, Karen, calm down. Honestly, who cares if I just have to eat Brussels sprouts? Whatever, let's just get through this so I don't have to talk to the waiter again.
It's whatever!
Wait a minute. Karen, is that what you actually ordered?
Yes, Sean.
You bet.
I'm sorry, did I mess up your order? I'm so sorry.
No, it's fine. I'll just eat this.
No, seriously, it'll just take me a few minutes to fix it. Let me go get it for you.
I think we're good, thank you. Oh my goodness, I'm literally about to vomit.
Just as I expected, we've fallen into yet another classic predicament, not speaking truthfully. Just look at Karen's face here. That is not someone who is enjoying their day, to say the least. Let's see what happens if instead Karen chooses to do just as Jesus would. Let's rewind and let her cook.
Step off, woman.
How did Uzbekistan not go to war for that?
I can't believe he just got my order wrong. Okay, calm down, Karen. This guy has been so nice. Think, how would Jesus handle this situation?
I'm sorry, but this isn't actually what I ordered.
Oh, really? I'm so sorry. I really thought you said Brussels sprouts.
No, I didn't, and unfortunately, I just don't like Brussels sprouts. Is there any way you could help me get what I originally ordered?
Yeah, for sure. And I'm really sorry. I did not mean to mess this up.
Of course you didn't. And I'm not mad at you. Mistakes like this happen all the time.
Okay, could you remind me what you ordered?
The chicken tartare. Won't that take too long to make, though? Because otherwise I can just order something that's easier.
No, it won't. Let me go put that in and I'll bring it right back out in just
Thank
a few minutes.
Thank you so much. You know, that was really nice of him.
That is how we respond to someone with the love of Jesus. We don't just pretend to be nice to them to get rid of them. And we definitely don't be mean about it. We just love how Jesus loves. We have to shine his light bright no matter where we are. If you do that, then even though life probably still won't go how we expect, we can know that we're loving others in just the way God wants us to. My name has been Dr. Ness. Well, that doesn't matter. Thanks for joining. Have a lovely evening, and God bless.